Hello once again, graduates, and welcome to our lesson channel. I want first of all to remind you about the diagram shown on the board there, and we call this the three computing stages, and I hope you are able to remember that. And we looked at the inputs and the output devices, which I'm pretty sure you are all able to list the items or components or devices which can be called input devices and those which are output devices. Input devices, we looked at the keyboards, then we came to look at the pointing devices like the mouse. We looked at the joystick, the touch pads, the stylus pen, the trackable, and the others. And we also came to look at the readers or data capture devices, like the family of scanners, where we had the OCR or MR. We looked at the magnetic ink character recognitions, the barcode reader, and the camera in that category. Then we also jumped to the output devices there. We discussed the soft copy and hard copy devices, where we say that soft copy devices, they represent information on the screen, like on the monitor or the projector, or the screen of the phone, the smartphone, of course. Then we talked about the hard copy devices, and those are devices which are able to produce output on paper. A printed copy, we said it's a hard copy. And we talked about various types of printers in that category. But today, we want to look at the processing stage. At the processing stage there are two things involved there. We've got the processing and we've got the storage. And under this topic, it refers to us the three computing stages. So this topic came from the three computing stages. We covered the input and we finished the output. And today we want to work on the two components in between, the processing and the storage. Stages of the three computing stages. So to begin with, we will start with looking at the processing stage. Processing stage. Obviously, processing refers to the conversion of raw fact data into meaningful information. And we say this is where data is converted into information. And at processing stage, that is where we've got a very important device or component. And this component is known as the microprocessor. It is the main component found at the processing stage. And the microprocessor is famously known as the brain of the computer. So basically, that's what people refer to as a CPU. But its real name is the microprocessor. And before we delve into the details of microprocessor, we want to give examples of the various types of microprocessors on the market. I was just checking online and I found that there is i1. It's one example of a microprocessor. There is i9, i8, i7 up to from i1 to i10. So i1 was the first processor in the series of i-series processors. If we ask you to give an example of a processor, you can mention anything from i1 to i10. But the thing is, i10 is the fastest in this category. So it's like the bigger the number, the faster and better the processor is. So this microprocessor is far much better than all the processors below. But before we started using i-series processors, we were using what we call Pentium processors. Pentium 1 up to Pentium 4. So Pentium 4 obviously was faster than the processors before it, like the processor 1, Pentium 1, Pentium 2, Pentium 3. Pentium 4Z far much faster. But we need to know that we are no longer mostly using these processors. We are now looking at the I family of processors. So good examples nowadays, you can give an example of the I series, like I1 up to I10. And if you want to go shopping for a computer, look for one with a better processor, because this is the brain of the computer. And talking in details about this brain of the computer, the processor, it is divided into two compartments. There is one area where it is called the control unit, and then there is where it is called the arithmetic logic unit. So when we enter data into the computer system, it straight goes to the control unit. That's why in the three computing stages, from input you go straight to processing, and the data being entered into the computer system goes to the control unit. The control unit receives data entered into the computer system, then it controls this data and allow some data to go to the ARU and fetch the data back from the ARU to the control unit before it can send the data to RAM. Remember the random access memory we discussed about, which we actually said it's the workspace of the computer. So any data when it is coming to the computer system goes to the control unit. And in the control unit, we can receive a lot of data at the same time. And that data will be treated in first in, first out. So what that means is that the data that goes into the CPU first is the data that will be processed first before the data that comes later on. So to avoid confusion, the control unit has storage spaces. Let's say these are the storage spaces of the control unit. And the storage spaces for the control unit are known as registers. Very important definitions to understand. So the registers are the temporal storage spaces found in the control unit. Because as data is coming to the computer system, it goes to the control unit. The first data to go to the control unit will be stored there. Then the following data there, just like that. Why is data arranged in that fashion? It's because there is only one item of data that can go for processing in the ARU. The ARU is responsible for data processing, for the conversion of raw facts into information. That takes place in the ARU. And the ARU can only process one type of data at a time. So if we enter a lot of data into the computer system, the control unit will hold on to some data and store them temporarily into those registers until the processing is done in the ARU. That's when that data will be fetched out of the ARU back to the control unit, then sent to RAM, and then it will appear on the screen or the monitor of the computer. Basically, that's the function of the control unit. And it has these storage spaces we call registers. And the data in the registers are stored in first in, first out services. So which means the data that goes into the CPU first, it will occupy possibly that. And the following that register, the following that register, and the etc. Until all the data is processed, then the data which is in the ARU, when it is processed, that is when the data stored in the first register of the control unit will be taken to the ALU. After this one is processed, then the next one will move into that register, then it will be taken to, for processing and out. And this is the cycle that a CPU works on. So the part of the CPU or the processor which is responsible for data processing, it's the ALU. This is where arithmetic calculation are done, comparisons are done there, and the conversion of data into information is done in the arithmetic logic unit. It's very important that you remember that. Then, from there, we also need to understand the speed of the processor. We may say that the processor speed is measured in megahertz and gigahertz, and that is millions cycles per second, billion cycles per second. But nowadays, the processor speeds are coming in gigahertz per second. When we say gigahertz, we're talking about a billion per second. A human being, if I want to count from 1 to 9, no sooner as I count 1, that is almost a second has gone. But a computer in a second would have counted from 1 to 1 billion. That is the speed of the computer. So when you're saying 1, the computer has gone from 1 to 1 billion. And there are processors which count more than 1 billion at a time. There are those which are 2.8 gigahertz a second. So they are able to count more than 2 billion times at a second. Within a second, they are able to count that. Why is this speed so very important? It is so very important. Let me give you an example from my system here, where suppose I've got a Word document on my screen. Can I open a new one? New document. Opened a lot of files. Word document. Okay. For instance, I have this Word document. On my keyboard, I want to type the letter A. And there, A, and it appears on the screen. This A has appeared on the screen no sooner I pressed it up from the keyboard. And it appears automatically, like it just comes from the keyboard straight to Microsoft Word document. And it appears automatically. The more I type some more characters, the more they appear on the screen. And it's almost telling me that it's coming straight from the keyboard to the screen. And in fact, that is not right. It's not like it's coming from the keyboard outside there to the from the keyboard and straight going to output on the screen. It's not appearing, it's not happening like that. Exactly what is happening that when you enter the character, it is going to the control unit, then taken for processing to the ALU, then back from the ALU to the control unit, sent to RAM, then it goes to the output. But it so appears like automatic because of the same speed I'm talking about, billions per second. It is so fast that you may think that it is you are typing automatically from keyboard to the screen. But all these stages are catered for. So basically that's what happens at the processing stage. And this is where the theory of computing lies. And if you want to enjoy computing, ensure you look for a processor which is so fast. 2.8 gigahertz, it may sound to be fast, but there are processors faster than this. Also look into the category of the I series, I1, I2, I3. The computer I'm using right now, this same computer, it is I3, which is about 2.9 gigahertz. But they are faster computers nowadays, far much better than the one I am using right now. So when you go shopping for a computer, consider the speed of the processor and the make of the processor. They matter a lot in data processing. So today, we're just going to cover processing, and I hope next time we are going to tackle what we call storage, because storage is also part of the processing cycle. When data comes for processing, it's supposed to be stored there. So I've just covered the processing today. Next time we'll look at the storage. And I hope that this lesson has made a lot of sense and will be able to pass when the exam is set. So ensure you watch the videos. I'll give you the notes. I'll post them on the e-learning management for the school. Until next time, enjoy your holiday.